So why I came here? So I think the first thing was I saw in Geneva, in English it's a shell, yes? A shell on the Bourg de Four, which is a place in Geneva. And I always thought, oh, what's that? So I heard it's Saint-Jacques-de-Compostelle. And I thought one day I'm going to do a little trip, but I thought it's going to be long, long term, something in 10 years or something like that.
Vous partez par la montagne. Normal.
So when I decided to quit my job, I thought that's the occasion or never, because I can have 2 weeks of holidays, 2 weeks by my own, without kids, without husband, without anything, just to be by my own. And I wanted a place to be safe, where I can meet people if I want, where I can be alone if I want to, not too much organization. And be able to walk. I wanted to walk. I don't know why, because I never really was a person who likes walking. For me, the reason really it's I don't know how to say in English. It's like a possibility to focus on yourself. What do I really want? Where I want really to go? And well, yes, what I really want in my life and in general. With the family, with friends, with work, friends situation.
Daily feels like there's nothing to do. My name is Paul Anthony Stephen Clark.
Yeah.
Paul. And I am from Ohio, but I've transplanted to New Orleans, Louisiana. I made the Camino de Santiago. I was a pilgrim, un peregrino, on the Camino de Santiago 5 years ago when I was in Spain, when I studied here at in Madrid. We had a week off for Semana Santa, for Holy Week. And I thought, what better thing to do during Holy Week than to just walk with the Lord and to approach Him and to ask Him to, you know, I want to give you everything, Lord. And the idea of a pilgrimage, how it unifies our body and soul. We feel the pain in our body. We feel distracted and cold, windy, as you know, as the wind kind of cuts through us, and that becomes the whole focus of where we're at in that moment. And yet there's a call to more. There's a call to say, there is so much more to this world, and I want to share it with you, Lord, so that I can experience everything that you have to offer and share it with others. So being a pilgrim is to be open, to receptive, you know, as you meet people, to share stories, you know, to hear where people are going, and if it's to share a prayer, just to listen, whatever it is, that is that moment of relationship and touch and togetherness.
My name is Santos. I'm French, and I'm living in the center of France. And I start the Camino from the city named Le Puy. I think the Camino for me is we are disconnected, from the world. We are in the nature, no more problems, no, we are with our birds, the scenery, and normally you are different when you arrive in Santiago, but without the Catholic, just because you are in the nature during 2 months, you change. Automatically you change.
I think the Camino just started. The first day I realized that when you want to go somewhere, you have to leave the past. And that's the most difficult thing. So I was thinking like, oh, I want to go home, I want to be with my kids and husband. And at the same time I was thinking, but I want to continue my way and go to Burgos for myself. And it was just this discovery, which isn't really a discovery, but it made me realize, yes, you have to leave something behind you to be able to go forward. So that was my first lesson, but I don't have any more lessons until now. I'm waiting for the future.
There's friends I go out with, friends that I know. Lately it feels like there's nothing to do. My best friend, she packed her and left with her lover. Left me alone with a memory of you. Bittersweet memory, I'll tangle you.
Et aujourd'hui, ici à Saint-Jean-Pied-de-Port, on se voit, et on peut passer soit par la montagne, soit par la route ici. Bon, ici aussi, des deux côtés, moi, depuis qu'on arrive à la même altitude.
Seminary formation, and this is what I've been doing this time, and I've only been on the way for one day now, but one of the things that is part of seminary formation is a commitment to develop the habit, it is a habit, the habit of reading and praying the Liturgy of the Hours, which is the divine office of the Church prayed by all the religious and all the ordained priests, all the priests. They take it on as a vow. Or as a promise that they will pray this, and they are praying it not for themselves, but for the bride, the Church. And the Church is the bride. And then take time during the afternoon to take a little moment and just reflect and recenter. And then in the evening to do the same, Vespers, to come together, you know, to come before the Lord and say, this is great moment where you are preparing me for what we, you know, might call it a practice death or a mini death. That as evening goes on, night falls, and with night, you know, there's a certain kind of sense that the end is coming. You know, each day has an end. And each, you know, day has a beginning, so it becomes the kind of, you enter into that as you kind of get ready, and then the very last prayer is Compline, or it's, you know, it's called Completas in Spanish, which means completion, and it's, you pray right before going to bed, night prayer, and one of the best parts of it is the Canticle of Simeon, in which Simeon the prophet says, Lord, now you let your servant go in peace, and that's what I desire, you know, just to give my life over to him, and then just to say, may I die with you, may I also rise with you.
I don't know who was saying that. It's if you don't have a objective, can you say objective in English? For yourself, people are going to find you one.
Plenty of people are Catholic.
I don't know anybody.
Many are not Catholic, and every people do the Camino for different
a way to give us time in everyone, wherever they're coming from, to give us time just to walk, to reflect, to meditate, to pray, to journal. Is to think about our lives in a really serious and just an honest way. And it, you know, it doesn't have to be too, I guess, grandiose, very simple. And I guess the Camino provides that simplicity because it's your way, your time, and your will in many sense. If you don't want to go on, you don't go on. But why do you want to go on? And, you know, these questions of why do you want to do this? Why is this so important? Why not just stay home and, or, you know, go to the beach? Why, you know, why put yourself through, you know, days when you're having, when you'll take a cold shower and you don't get the kind of rest that you want and you have a blister and, you know, or something, you know, really bad happens and you just, you don't know how to respond. These are these moments that help us grow, to grow on, to grow up. And I think for everyone, wherever they're at, the Camino will provide a great gift, an incredible gift that's, you know, that is truly worth the way. It's truly worth the way.